Yeah. Almost 50 years I've been in.
And I wouldn't miss one minute of it, old girl. Remember the day we first came up here to this place, Esther?
Shouldn't remember such things.
Why not? We was married, wasn't we?
And then there was the day I come running up here when I found out I was in the family way. Scared as a cottontail. And then you found me and everything was all right.
I was scared too, Esther. You know, you're such a tiny little thing. All I want to do is to protect you, give you the moon and all the trimmings. And all I have ever been able to give you is just a piece of this good earth and one another. I guess that's about all anyone's meant to have. The best there is, anyway.
Young people don't know what's important. Memories are important. They can't take them away from you.
We've had some good times, haven't we, Esther?
I was born in East Virginia, North Carolina, I did roam. There I met a fair and pretty maiden, her name and age I do not know. Her hair it was of brightsome color, and her lips of ruby red. On her breast she wore white lilies. There I longed to lay my head.
And how he does believe that mine is the sweetest of them all. Well, I says to myself, he's just trying to sweet talk you, old woman. Then that's when he started telling about his road. He hunkers down by the tree there. And he says, Miss Walton, two lanes of my blacktop highway are going to come around that curve and cut through those trees, through your house, and right smack through your tomato patch. Pretty soon now. Lord, I said, you sure are planning the smell of gasoline and rubber tires burning on a hot road being plentiful around here, aren't you? He says, yes, ma'am. It's the way it's going to be, for a fact. Well, I think he's the one whose facts are confused.
Hi. All these? If I buy it by the pound, you'll end up with about 50 cents. I'll give you 75.
A dollar.
Did somebody tell you that you got a bargain with Vernon?
I need the money. Every cent counts.
Well, I could say 80 cents, but then you'd ask for 95. But who has all day? All right, a dollar. I didn't know what I bought. I threw all that junk in my truck and drove off.
Well, Mary Ellen had no business selling it.
Was it stolen goods?
No, Vernon, just a mistake.
I hope you're willing to sell it back to me.
Please, sit down.
Thank you, Vernon. Sell it, did you, Vernon?
To Davidson. He's a junk man, too. Not like me. He's a pretty big junk man. He travels in a huge truck. Texas to Vermont to Florida. Lucky man.
Thank you. She never wants to hear about the recipe. Have you noticed that, sister?
Strange, isn't it? Well, aren't we lucky, sister?
Pints instead of quarts.
I know.
In the beginning, God created heaven and earth. And the earth was without form, and void and darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. And God spoke, "Let there be light."
Here's to my cousins. I swear the two of you get more beautiful with each passing year.
Oh, listen to Homalee and that silver tongue.
Reminds me of Ashley Longworth.
Ashley Longworth, Ashley. Oh, he's the young man your papa had to shoot, was he not?
Oh, papa never shot. He just shook the gun at Ashley and suggested he leave.
And he left like a flash.
But he had taken liberties, had he not?
Kissed me. Out there under the maple tree.
And, no talk of marriage?
None whatsoever.
I figure we got some talking to do, John boy. I'm real sorry about last night.
Sorry for what you did? You sorry you got caught?
Well, I came here because I wanted to explain to you.
Nancy, you don't have anything to explain to me. I just saw you steal something.
Now, John boy, steal's a kind of harsh word, isn't it? I'd like you to know why I borrowed them chickens. Well, sir, there's a lot of people in this county who just can't seem to make ends meet. And there's others like, well, old Charlie Potter, who got more than they need. So every once in a while, I borrow from him who has and give them who haven't.
Robin Hood, huh?
Well, now, I admit I have heard about that old boy. But the gospel truth is, John boy, I never took nothing for myself, only for them I knew to be needful.
How old are you, Cody?
As of today, I'm 64 years old.
Congratulations. Now you can start growing young again.
Young? I'm afraid not. I've invested a lifetime in growing old. Just to reach the age of 65 and retire.
Now, that's a good idea. But around here, you don't retire until you die.
Can you hear me talking to you? Tell me something. Talk to me. What's your name?
The Ebony Flash.
We got to start, Bertie. We want that church for him and for us.
Mr. Walton, whatever lumber this will buy, it will be the foundation for our church.
Maybe I didn't lose.
Maybe not.
By the throne of God.
isn't it? Hey, you know, he's pretty good.
Does that mean I get the job?
Well, sure. We'll try it and see how it works out.
Oh, well, great. Thank you.
Oh, that's wonderful. Hey, look, we've got a piano player here. Nice kid. Nothing but ginger ale, don't you?
Oh, yes, ma'am.
Okay. Sure.
Afternoon, Olivia.
Afternoon, Chef.
John, boy. Wash day, huh?
Every day's wash day with this crowd.
John around?
He and Grandpa are up to Rockfish delivering some railroad ties.
And what time you be back?
About a half hour, I reckon.
Something wrong, Chef?
Well, I just want to tell John tonight before he goes to bed, lock up all them doors and windows.
Why?
It's that carnival down the road. Last night after the show, the manager ran off with the cash and left them all stranded. Took the snake charmer's wife along with him. Anyway, I guess the rest of the folks figured there wasn't much point sticking around, so they hightailed it out of town with their trucks. Trouble is, they left four people here.
Where are they now?
I don't know. Skulking around somewhere, I guess. I hear tell they got no respect for other people's ways or property. Drinking, smoking, carrying on. Mind you, you tell John to keep everything under lock and key.
Which way would you say, sister?
The signpost puts Richmond to the right.
Fork in the road is always a challenge, or at least it's meant to be, I believe.
Not if there's a signpost.
I have a preference for the least traveled roads. How do you feel about roads, sister?
I have only the feeling that the signpost puts Richmond to the right.
Well, then that means that Walton's Mountain must be to the left.
What are you doing here?
We heard that you were lonely, so we came to keep you company.
I'm not hiring.
You're not hiring because there's nobody left to hire.
Word is out on this place and the way you're running it.
I'm getting along just fine.
Do yourself a favor, Mr. Pickett. For 1 minute, try to forget I'm black. I'll try to forget you're white. Look at me and see a college-trained expert in personnel. Somebody who can screen the job applicants, keep the best, and put them in the jobs they're qualified to do.
One person decides who works here and who don't. Me.
You had it that way, J.D. Look where it's gotten you.
Mr. Pickett, if you were bleeding to death and a doctor knelt down beside you to try and save your life, would you send him away because he was black?
All right, so I've been having a little trouble and... maybe you could help.
They're all gone, son.
I'd like to get my things, and I'd be obliged for a lift to the nearest bus stop.
What about the all-day service?
I recognize how hollow and righteous all my words were. Both of you were quicker to realize that than I was.
What are you going to do?
I guess my call to the ministry was faulty. I'll try to be worthy of whatever else the Lord wants me to do with my life.
You're quitting?
I don't see as I have any choice. A man cannot ask other men to lead their lives better than he is capable of himself.
This is Grandma's room. You'll be staying here. She's in Buckingham County, going from cousin to cousin.
Oh, isn't this just peachy? Esther must be a wonderful woman if she's anything like this room. I always say you can tell a person by the kind of house they keep.
Grandma'd want you to stay here while she's away. We cleaned out some of those drawers and you can hang some of your clothes in that closet.
Kate told me about your boy missing in action. It's the saddest thing I ever heard.
We just keep praying that John Boy will be all right.
He will, Olivia. I know. I just feel it in my bones. That slip's got more wrinkles in it than a preacher's Bible.
If you leave it out, it's my ironing day. I'll press it for you.
Oh, no, you don't. I'm going to do the ironing or anything else that needs doing around here. I want to make myself useful.
Whitley House window. Zebulon Walton, will you never stop surprising me?
Well, you always said you wanted to see what Walton's Mountain looked like through the Whitley House window.
Do you remember that tune from somewhere?
Yes, I played it for you on the front porch of the old Whitley place. We went there for a dance one night. I thought about it when I was bringing the window over here today. I remember something else, too. Out there on the porch, you sort of reached up your arms and you gave me a little peck.
You kissed me.
Oh, so I did. I just listened to it, Esther. Brings it all back, doesn't it? Well, I thought you'd forgotten.
The window was just the beginning. My father and grandfather parceled out the doors and mantels and paneling of the old Whitley House to our friends and neighbors. Somehow, that bit of history in each of their homes brought us all a little closer together.
Grandpa, is the lightning rod working?
You go to sleep, Jim Bob. I'll wake you up the first sign that the lightning rod is doing its duty.
Night, Grandpa.
Yes, sir. Would I rate a good night kiss? Well.
What's wrong?
You kissed me. I'd have sworn the lightning rod brought a bolt smack down here in the room with us.
Oh, you big talk.
Good night, everybody.